In this video, we will download and install Google Chrome and Notepad++. These two programs will be used extensively in this course to write and test our code. Let's begin. First, I'll open Microsoft Edge, the default web browser that comes with Windows 10. In the address bar, I'll type Google Chrome download. Press enter on the keyboard, then I'll click the first link, Google Chrome, download Chrome today. When the page opens, I'll click the download Chrome button. I'll quickly read the end user licensing agreement, then click accept and install. At the bottom of the screen, I'm given several options. I'll select run. When I choose Run, I may automatically see a window open, or I may need to click the shield at the bottom. When I click the shield, the window opens, and it asks, "Do you want this to allow this application to make changes to your device?" I'll click Yes. In a few moments, the program will download. Shortly after that, the program will begin installing. This will take a couple of seconds. Please be patient. After the installation completes, Google Chrome will open automatically on your desktop. With Chrome open, we'll next download and install Notepad++. I'll type Notepad++ downloads in the address bar. I'll press enter on the keyboard. Then I'll select the first link, Downloads Notepad++. There are a number of different releases. I'm going to choose the most recent one, which is 7.8.5. If you see a newer release, you can select that instead. Next, I'll choose the download 64-bit version. This will work best with our Windows 10 operating system. I'll choose the installer option because this will be the easiest to work with. After clicking installer, you'll notice in the bottom left corner of Chrome, the Notepad++ 7.8.5 installer .exe file appears. I'll click on this file. Then I'll click Yes to answer the question, "Do you want to allow this application to make changes to your device?" Next, I'll choose a language, which is English, and I'll click OK. I'll click Next to move through the setup process now. I'll again quickly read the licensing agreement. I'll click the I agree button. And I'll choose the destination folder, which is in the program files on the C drive, Notepad++. I'm going to leave the default components and click Next. Lastly, I'll click the Install button and the installation process begins. When the installation process is complete, I'll click the Finish button and Notepad++ will appear on my screen. Lastly, I'm going to add Launch in Chrome to the Run menu. You'll notice if I go to the Run menu now, Launch in Chrome is not one of the options. I'm going to change that by adding Launch in Chrome to the menu. First, I'll click the Run command. In the Run command dialog box, I'll click the three dots, which is called the Build button. Next, I'm going to go on the left-hand side of my screen to This PC. I'll double-click Local Disk C, I'll double-click Program Files x86, I'll open up Google, I'll double-click Chrome, I'll open Application, and lastly, I'll double-click the Chrome application. Now before I click Save, I want to add some additional information. I'll click in the text box, then I'll click at the very end of the line. After the double quote, I'm going to add a space. I'm going to add another double quote, a dollar sign, a left parenthesis, and in capital letters, F-U-L-L underscore C-U-R-R-E-N-T underscore P-A-T-H. I'll close the parentheses and I'll add another double quote. That's double quote, dollar sign, left parentheses, full underscore current underscore path, right parentheses, double quote. The reason that I'm adding this information is if we were to just run the command as it was, it would open Chrome in the default page. By adding full current path, this will open whatever file we were working in Notepad++. I'll click the Save button now, and I'll give my shortcut a name. I'll type the name Launch in Chrome. I'll add the following shortcut keys: Control, Alt, Shift, and the letter R. I'm choosing this because that's the one that was chosen by Notepad. I'll click OK, and now I'll test out my work. I can click Cancel, and you'll notice in the Run menu, launching Chrome is one of the options. If I click away and then open an HTML file, I can test my shortcut. Here's a simple HTML file. I can choose Run, launching Chrome, and the HTML file is rendered in the browser. Thanks for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this video.